So when I started going down the road of looking for a cordless welder, I was tasked by a customer that they didn't want a bunch of cords. They didn't want a bunch of bottles. So I didn't know what I was gonna do. So luckily I stumbled across my brand that was coming out with the Renegade.
Well, and the problem we had in this particular facility, they don't have any 240 power. They barely have any 110 volt power. So to be able to weld in there, I was stringing 400 foot of cord.
And then you cause a tripping hazard. Well, they're very big on safety. They're one of the companies that require us to be in a VETA. We were freaking out. We didn't know how we're gonna get this job done.
I just recently discovered that, ESAB came out with these great little suckers. And I'm like, this is the only thing I'm gonna be able to use, because I can go in there on pure battery, not even plugged into a cord whatsoever. We brought a couple of these, multiple sets of batteries, did that, never strung a cord all day. It was amazing.
Another choice feature of the VOLT is to where we can use the batteries when we don't get enough voltage from the system that we're plugged into. A lot of times we go into older manufacturing facilities that have old grids or old power systems. So even the 180s sometimes, if you're plugged straight in, we blow breakers.
Some facilities, when you blow a breaker, it can be absolute hell.
Tripping a breaker can turn into a 2-hour event for us, depending on which facility we're working in. So being able to use this to pull the extra juice we need from the batteries is phenomenal. The Renegade VOLT, the battery-powered kick-ass toy. I love that thing. It's a lifesaver if you don't have power with you.